Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about teeth shape and how that affects orthodontics and what our options are and what patients sometimes might ask for and even what doctors often ask me for. So what's possible, what's not possible? And sometimes we don't really notice that patients kind of have uniquely or funky shaped teeth until we straighten them up and we look at the ClinCheck and we're like, is that a space? Is that... It's not a black triangle because black triangle's up here, you know? So I call this tapered teeth is what I call them. And sometimes we have square shaped teeth. Sometimes we have tapered taped teeth. Sometimes we have triangular shaped teeth. So black triangle was more like a triangle shaped teeth, right? And then the space is here, but it's touching down here. This is the opposite. So often I get asked, okay, well, and this is something that really bothers me that they teach in some GP ortho programs that it's okay to go ahead and swing the roots distally. Now, if you swing the roots distally, sure, that's going to approximate these segments more. Now, what else is going to happen? First of all, from a health perspective, why would you blindly want to swing your roots distally? Because I know I'm going to have to swing them at least 10, 20, 30 degrees in order to make this look better and still not going to look great. And then the roots are going to be going this direction, and they're going to run into the roots of the tubes. And now we just possibly damaged our roots, caused root resorption, may need endo, might lose the tooth. I mean, why, you know? Why do you want to do that? That's not the way you're meant to leave to finish your ortho treatment. Ortho treatment is supposed to be finished with parallel roots, not funky tipped roots, okay? If you do that, because the patient's begging you to, first of all, patient wouldn't even understand that, so you'd have to bring it up. Second of all, if you do that and the patient disappears and goes to another dentist and they take an x-ray and they see those roots like that, they're going to be like, who damaged your roots? And that could be a major liability for you, even though the patient told you to do it, supposedly. Don't do it. Just say no. So also what's going to happen if you do that is that these distal aspects are going to hang down lower. Okay, so the mesial aspect is going to go up, the distal is going to hang down, and you're still going to have to restore it anyways. It's going to look really dumb. I mean, you don't want to go whacking off the whole distal aspect on somebody's tooth. Just say no, put the teeth parallel, and let the patient know ahead of time, hey, it's going to look like there's space, but it's actually touching right here. There is no way for me to fix this without doing just some easy composite. You can do a composite laminate. You can do a four-surface composite. We could do a veneer, actual veneer. I mean, especially since these teeth are kind of funky shapes anyways, they're very rounded. It's going to look better when this person grows up to have four veneers, you know, as opposed to just two. That would look, or four really nicely shaped composites for now. So I really love it when you bundle that into the big price of the treatment. So we've got the ortho, but part of the ortho is also going to do the restorative. It's not going to look great. It's not going to be done until the restorative is done. So let's go ahead and collect the deposit on all of that, get you committed to the whole treatment plan. And then one thing you can actually do if you're using Invisalign is you can use the Invisalign export feature. And I do have videos on that. If you want to search them up, go into my YouTube channel. To get there, go to Straight Smile Solutions YouTube channel. Go to the little magnifying glass in the top right and put in, for example, export. That keyword, and I'll take you to the Invisalign export feature, which allows you to export the final STL, which would be this version where everything was done, and then you can export it to your lab. Not all labs take STLs from Align Technology iTeros, so you might want to ask them if they'll take that STL. Now keep in mind, once you activate that STL, Invisalign does have a pop-up alert that comes up saying, hey, if you choose to proceed with this, we are going to bill you if you do not accept this treatment. And I don't know how much the bill is. They don't say. It's probably a couple hundred. So you only want to hit that export feature, I say, if the case has already been approved, to be honest. That way you can export that to your lab. They can create a digital wax up, which is a few hundred dollars, and the patient has the ability to see what it's going to look like once you do the virtual wax up. And if there was some issue about, you know, moving things around or moving teeth around or, you know, extruding or intruding or leveling out gum lines, you could always, maybe you want to intrude this too so you have the gum lines a little more even. Who knows? Okay. So let the lab tech tell you how to do it. And there is a feature, DSD, Digital Smile Design, does collaborate directly with Invisalign, and they can also do it. But I heard it's a lot, like $400 or $500. All right. Thanks so much.